Making a 3D shooter game in Unity is very, very easy. Just stay with us until the end of the video. I prepared a 3D city before. You should have something like this for sure. When you create that, right click and create an object as player. Add character controller component to manage player's movement. Import joystick pack package from asset store or package manager like me. Rename the object as player. Right click on player and create a camera. Set your camera position to get a better view. This is my camera view. Now when character turns, camera turns with it too. Let's move character with joystick. Right click on hierarchy and create a canvas from UI options. Now from imported package at prefab folder, make fix a joystick canvas child. You can see a joystick is added to the scene. Set its position. Let's work with code. Open player script, define a public character controller called CH and a public joystick called joystick. For moving character with character controller, use these codes. If you don't know what are these codes, its tutorial is in the channel. Everything is clear. You can, instead of 10, put another number for speed. In bottom line, write ch.move, in parentheses write defined vector 3. I mean move. Now with this command, character goes left, right, forward and backward by character controller. Give a script to player, then give character controller to ch, and joystick to joystick. After play, you can use joystick to move the character either on PC or on phone. There is a point about gravity in the character controller, which we will discuss later. Now let's move camera or character's head for looking at different directions. Open the script and define this stuff. I wanna change looking direction in phone by touch method. If you wanna do this with mouse in PC, it is too easy, only watch this tutorial. Create a late update void, write in it mouse x equals to first touched position dot delta position dot x times speed times time dot delta time. Now we wanna turn character's body with mouse x followed. So write body dot rotate in parentheses vector 3 dot up and mouse x. Do the same for mouse y, only instead of x write y and instead of vector 3 dot up write vector 3 dot left. Now click on player. Give camera to head and give player to body. Press play. Now when you move your finger across the touch screen, character view changes. Which has a bug here. When you move joystick, character's head moves with it. And if you touch anywhere else, the camera view gets messed up again. And also we have an error. It is for when we don't touch the script. To fix this bug and error, open the script. Write if input.touchCount was greater than 0, which means if a screen is touched, whole if body runs. Write another if, which it cuts the screen in half, right side and left side. And when you touch right side, this if command executes. Get a copy from all of it, in parentheses instead of 0, write 1 for second touch. Now write another if like me, if touch count was equal to 1 and if touch count was equal to 2. We need another copy, so we put it here. Let me explain briefly. Up here we written if a screen was being touched. Below it, we written if there was one touching position and it was at right side of a screen rotate camera. And below it, we said if there was two touching position, if any of these two touches was at the right side of a screen, rotate camera with it. After play, you can move character in any direction you want and look at different directions. Here is a point. We should limit view angle of character from up and down. We do it by a method called clamping. Before writing clamping command, to make the code short, define a new void called change view and in parentheses write int number. Now bring looking with touch code here and instead of this one write number. Then remove all commands up here. Instead of them write change view in parentheses based on get touch number write 1 or 0. Let's use clamping. which is tutorial is in the channel. Up here define a float, in change view void remove this section and write these commands in it. This negative 30 and positive 45 is the minimum and maximum angle that character can look up and down with it. After play, character's view is limited. Now let's give a gun to the character. This is a 3D gun model, make it grandchild of player. After set the gun position, look, the gun is not fully rendered. To fix it, in camera options, change near to 0.01. Set gun's position. Now it is what user sees from game. Create an image from UI section for gun crosshair. Change its picture and its size and its color as you want. For me, this red dot works out. Change its name as you want. I choose pointer. Let's see how character shoots. Open the script. Up here, use Unity Engine dot event systems. Down here, define a void called down. In parentheses, write base event data. Event data. Also, define two other voids called shooting and up. Do the same thing for up as you did for down. I will tell the reason of this event data ahead. In down void, use invoke repeating for running shooting void till character shoots. Write invoke repeating, in parentheses write desired void name, and 0 and its repeat rate. For me 0.1 works. Cancel this invoke in up void, in parentheses write shooting void. Create a new button and change its options as you want. Name it shooting for shooting. After that, add event trigger component. Add two new events called pointer down and pointer up. Click on these plus buttons, drag the player towards them, then choose two base event data voids, I mean down and up. We can simulate shooting by two methods. One of them is instantiate and another one is raycast. In this scenario, we use raycast method. Define a raycast hit called hit. Below it write physics.raycast, then in parentheses, here it wants camera position. So up here define a public camera called cam. Then write cam.transform.position. And in next part write cam.transform.forward. Then write out hit. And its range, precisely bullet range. For example, 100. Open Unity again, we have three particles. One of them is gunfire particle, which should be placed at the tip of the gun. Another one is shell particle, which throws out from gun. That should be thrown out from a precise location called shell position. So create a game object and place it where the shell is supposed to be ejected from. And last particle is impact point. So open the script, put raycast order in an if. At the top, define three game objects for prefabs. Gunfire particle should be played continuously, so write its playing order. Now write producing of impact point particle down here. Only here has a point. Write quaternion.lockRotation in parentheses hit.normal. In this way, if impact angle was 90 degrees, particle angle becomes 90 degrees. For example, if you shoot the floor, particle is seen upwards. Or if you shoot the wall, particle can be seen to the rear or front. And producing shell order. Produce it in shell position. So define a transform called shell position. Now those prefabs should be destroyed after 2 seconds. So we call them to A and B game object, and with destroy method destroy them after 2 seconds. Let's work with Unity. Select player, give camera to cam, give gun tip particle or gunfire or gunfire to gunfire prefab, give shell prefab to shell prefab, and give impact point to impact point prefab, and at last, give shell position to shell position. After play, I have an error. It says I wrote invoke repeating void wrongly. Yes, I wrote shoot instead of shooting. Press play. Look, character can move in different directions, can shoot different directions, impact point stays there. This is so good, but this shooting is so simple and it isn't natural. It needs some animations. Create a new animation called shooting. Right click on player and create an empty game object called animation or anim. Make camera and gun its child, press record button. Choose animation game object, change x of position and change camera field of view a bit. Now choose shooting animation that you made. Uncheck its loop time box. Create a new animation called idle. Choose animation game object. Change X a bit so that the player's posture resembles breathing. Now from animator window, make idle as default and make a transition between idle and shooting. Then create a trigger called shooting. Click on transition. Make all options 0 and click on this plus till shooting ends. Then make a transition between shooting and idle. Only set exit time on 0.99 and let exit time boxes to be checked. Now only we should active shooting trigger. In this way, anytime you shoot, shooting animation will play. Animator and animation full tutorial is in our channel. Check it. Now press play. Look, we can move character, its animation plays, and we can shoot. Now our shooting is so natural. Let's play shooting sound effect. If you like me have a pre-made shooting sound, bring it to the scene. Uncheck play on awake and put this option on linear. Define a sound effect in a script and play it in shooting void. Now give effect to shooting effect. If you press play, you will see character shooting looks much more natural. Last point is simulating gravity in character controller. Open the script. Up here define few things. A vector theory called gravity, a transform called ground checked, a layer mask called ground mask, and a boolean called is grounded. In update void above where we move character, right, is grounded equals to physics.checkSphere, then in parentheses right, groundCheck.position. And for radius, I think 0.4 is okay, and for last part, right, ground mask. In bottom line, right, if is grounded and gravity.y was smaller than 0, and in its body, right, gravity.y equals to 2. And at last, gravity.y plus equal negative 9.81. Which I wrote here wrongly 9.18, sorry about that. Make sure gravity is multiplied by time.delta time. Blow it, ch.move, and in parentheses gravity times time.delta time. Come back to Unity. Choose your grounds. I mean planes or trains or whatever. I choose some of grounds here. From layer section, add ground layer to it. And choose player. From ground mask section, select ground. Now right click on player. Create an empty game object and give it to ground check. Name it as ground check 2 and place it under player. Press play. Shit, why it's messed up? Oh, here instead of negative 2, we wrote positive 2. Fix it. Now after play, if you move character upward, gravity works. Let's see how we can shoot at enemies. Create a new script called enemy and open it. Define a new void called damage. Up here define an integer called health, for example equal it to 10. In damage void, subtract it by 2 and blow it, right? If health was equal or smaller than 0, destroy this game object. Open enemy script where you wrote recast commands in if right, enemy, a name for example enemy equals to hit.transform.getComponent enemy. Below it write if was not equal to null. In the body write enemy.damageWoid. Now what it means? Means if what raycast is in contact with had enemy script, run damageWoid. Now give a script to an object and shoot at it. After 5 bullets, object which is building here destroys. Now in damageWoid you can write any command you want. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe us. Thank you.